living fossils. You might have heard this term, living fossil. What does that mean? So it is like living organism that is extant species. Extinct means dead, right? The species is gone. Extant species, which are really old. The origin of that species has been in millions of years. Usually it is around 10 million years back, right? Origin of species till its extinction. The natural extinction events are mostly natural, except in the recent time, there has been a large number of extinction because of the human being. But if you look back in time, most of the extinction event had been natural, right? So like our own, birth, like human, right? So birth and death are, you know, there is no avoidances, right? These are like the destiny, or you can say this is like absolute truth. So whoever born, the person will die in one day, right? So same way the species, whenever species is formed, it will go extinct in one day, right? So the period between the lifetime, I mean the birth and death of the species, the lifetime of species can vary among the lineages. So some of these currently living extant species are really old. So that is called the living fossil. So basically, extant species originated hundreds of millions of years ago. That is what this living fossil is. You can say that cyanobacteria is also a living fossil because it has been originated really early on, 3.5 billion years. So just after the origin of life, which is a eubacteria, then, the cyanobacteria did form. So 3.5 billion years back and cyanobacteria is still living, isn't it? But yeah, of course, if you call the cyanobacteria at the higher level, the class level, then it's fine. But may not be the species. Some of the extant species are not that old, right? But yeah, in one sense, you can say the cyanobacteria was an example of, the living fossil, right? Like stromatolite, some of the fossils are really old, right? The oldest fossil you can say, definitively old. It's a stromatolites are definitely cyanobacterial biofilm. Another very interesting, this living fossil is silicate. This is from Africa, so some of the silicate material have been found, and yes, so silicate is living, currently living. You can go to these places and you can actually see it. It's deep sea fish, and this fish is at least 410 million years old. So so that means it has been it survived many mass extinction events, even Permian, the Great Death, and also KT extinction event. Every single extinction event this fish has survived and still living. Very interesting, isn't it? So another example of this living fossil is horseshoe crabs, 450 million years back. So it is also very, very old lineage currently living. So as a plant, Ginkgo biloba, it's a Chinese traditional medicine, which is often used in China, right? For in their form of healing. So yeah, so this is a very old lineage again, around 290 million years back. So it survived many of the extinction event too, so that is it's a very old lineage of plants, Ginkgo biloba. Then glyphoid lobsters are another such a living fossil. It is 250 million years ago that this particular lineage has formed. That means the species, origin of species happened on 250 million years back. And we also have this scorpion flies, This is also a very ancient, 200 million years back, right? Eumeropidae, that is the family of these scorpion flies. This is also a living fossil. And finally, we also have soft sea urchins, Echinotheroidea. That is what the family of this soft sea urchin, which is also immensely old, 174 million years ago, right? The origin of that lineage happened. So usually you see most of the species from the species origin to going extinct is around 10 million years. But these are exception, real exception, right? 174 million years back originated and still it's living. That is why these are called living fossils,